something wrong with him.
All right, Joey, be nice. So, does he have a hump and a hairpiece?
Wait, does he eat chalk? Just because I don't want her to go through what I went through with Carl. Oh.
Okay, everybody relax. Relax, this is not even a date. It's not, it's just two people going out to dinner and not having sex.
Sounds like a date to me. Alright, so I'm back in high school. I'm standing in the middle of the cafeteria and I realize I am totally naked. Then I look down and I realize there is a phone there.
Instead of...
That's right. All of a sudden, the phone starts to ring. Now, I don't know what to do. Everybody starts looking at me.
They weren't looking at you before?
Finally, I figure I'd better answer it. And it turns out it's my mother. Which is very, very weird because she never calls me.
This guy says, hello, I want to kill myself.
You okay, sweetie?
I just feel like someone reached down my throat, grabbed my small intestine, pulled it out of my mouth, and tied it around my neck.
Cookie?
Carol moved your stuff out today. Let me get you some coffee.
Thanks. No, don't. Stop cleansing my aura.
Stop.
No, just leave my aura alone, okay?
Fine. Be murky.
I'll be fine, all right? Really, everyone, I hope she'll be very happy.
No, you don't.
No, I don't. To hell with her. She left me.
You never knew she was a lesbian.
She didn't know. How should I know?
Sometimes I wish I was a lesbian. Did I say that out loud?
I told Mom and Dad last night. They seemed to take it pretty well.
Oh, really? So that hysterical phone call I got from a woman sobbing at 3 a.m., I'll never have grandchildren, I'll never have grandchildren, was what, a wrong number?
Sorry.
All right, Ross, look. You're feeling a lot of pain right now. You're angry. You're hurting. Can I tell you what the answer is? Strip joints! Come on, you're single. Have some hormones.
See, but I don't want to be single, okay? I just want to be married again.
And I just want $1 million!
Oh, God, Monica, hi, thank God. I just went to your building and you weren't there, and then this guy with a big hammer said that you might be here, and you are.
Mitchell, a Heather Lincoln High survivor. This is everybody. This is Chandler, Phoebe, and Joey. And you remember my brother Ross?
Sure.
So you want to tell us now, or are we waiting for four wet bridesmaids?
Oh, God. Well, it started about a half hour before the wedding. I was in this room where we were keeping all the presents, and I was looking at this gravy boat. This really gorgeous Limoges gravy boat. When all of a sudden I realized, sweet and low, I realized that I was more turned on by this gravy boat than by Barry. And then I got really freaked out, and that's when it hit me how much Barry looks like Mr. Potato Head.
Trouble.
Look, Dad.
nice, calm things.
Raindrops on roses and doorbells and sleigh bells and something with mittens. La la la, something and noodles with string.
I'm all better now. You know, independence, taking control of your life, the whole hat thing.
And hey, you need anything, you can always come to Joey. Me and Chandler live right across the hall, and he's away a lot.
Joey, stop hitting on her. It's her wedding day.
What? Like there's a rule or something?
I got it. Please don't do that again. It's a horrible sound.
It's Paul.
Oh, God. Is it 6:30? Buzz him in.
Who's Paul?
Paul the wine guy?
Paul? Maybe.
Wait a minute. You're not a real date tonight is with Paul the wine guy?
He finally asked you out?
Yes.
Ooh, this is a Dear Diary moment.
Wait. I can cancel. Oh, God, please. No, go. I'll be fine. Ross, are you okay? I mean, do you want me to stay?
That'd be good. No, go on. It's Paul the wine guy.
Does that mean, does he sell it, drink it, or he just complains a lot? Hi, come in. Paul, this is... Everybody?
Sorry, I didn't catch your name. Paul, was it?
Okay, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna go,
wandering?
Change. Okay, sit down. 2 seconds. Oh, I just pulled out 4 eyelashes. That can't be good.
Hey, Paul. Here's a little tip. She really likes it when you rub her neck in the same spot over and over and over again till it starts to get a little red.
So, Rachel, what are you up to tonight?
Well, I was kind of supposed to be headed for Aruba on my honeymoon, so nothing.
Right, you're not even getting your honeymoon. God. No, although, Aruba, this time of year, talk about your... big lizards. Anyway, if you don't feel like being alone tonight, Joey and Chandler are coming over to help me put together my new furniture.
Yes, and we're very excited about it.
No, actually, thanks, but I think I'm just gonna hang out here tonight. It's been a long day.
Oh, sure, okay, sure.
And Phoebs, you want to help?
Oh, I wish I could, but I don't want to.
Love is sweet as summer showers. Love is a wondrous work of art. But your love, your love, your love.
a brackety thing to the side things using a bunch of these little worm guys. I have no brackety thing. I see no worm guys whatsoever. And I cannot feel my legs. Thankfully, we got a bookcase here.
It's a beautiful thing.
What's this?
I would have to say that is an L-shaped bracket.
Which goes where?
I have no idea.
Down with the bookcase!
This was Carol's favorite beer. She always drank it out of the can. I should have known.
Hey.
If you're gonna start with that stuff, we're out of here.
Yes, please don't spoil all this fun.
Ross, let me ask you a question. She got the furniture, the stereo, the good TV. What did you get?
You guys.
Oh, God.
You got some...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
I know. I'm such an idiot. I guess I should have caught on when you started going to the dentist 4 and 5 times a week. I mean, how clean can teeth get?
My brother's going through that right now. He's such a mess. How did you get through it?
Well, you might try accidentally breaking something valuable of hers. Say her...
leg?
Oh, that's horribly everyone. Me, I went for the watch.
You actually broke her watch? Mm. Wow, the worst thing that I ever did was... I shredded my old boyfriend's favorite bath towel.
Ooh, steer clear of you.
That's right.
Barry, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I know you probably think this is all about what I said the other night about you making love with your socks on, but it isn't. It isn't. It's about me. And I didn't...
One woman. That's like saying... There's only one flavor of ice cream for you.
Let me tell you something, Ross. There's lots of flavors out there. There's Rocky Road and Cookie Dough and Bing Cherry Vanilla. You can get them with Jimmy's or nuts or whipped cream. This is the best thing that ever happened to you. You got married. You were like, what, 8? Welcome back to the world. Grab a spoon.
I honestly don't know if I'm hungry or horny.
Stay out of my freezer.
Ever since she walked out on me, I...
What? What? You want to spell it out with noodles?
No, it's more of a fifth date kind of revelation.
Oh, so there's gonna be a fifth date?
Isn't there?
Yeah, I think there is. What were you gonna say?
Well, ever since she left me, I haven't been able to perform sexually.
Oh God, I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I know being spit on is probably not what you need right now. How long?
2 years.
Wow. I'm glad you smashed your watch.
So you still think you, might want that fifth date?
Yeah, I do.
We are gathered here to join together Joni Louise Cunningham and Charles Chachi. In the bond of holy matrimony. Marriage is the most sacred.
See? But Joni left Chachi. That's the difference.
Grab a spoon. Do you know how long it's been since I grabbed a spoon? Do the words Billy, don't be a hero mean anything to you?
Great story. But I gotta go. I got a date with Andrea. Angela. Andrea. Oh, man.
Andrea's the screamer. Angela has cats.
Thanks. Julie, I'm out of here.
You know, here's the thing. Even if I could get it together enough to, you know, to ask a woman out, who am I gonna ask?
If you ever need holding, call my name, and I'll be there. If you ever need holding,
before in my entire life.
That is amazing. Congratulations.
You know, I figure if I can make coffee, there isn't anything I can't do.
No, I think it's if I can make Poland.
There isn't anything I can't do. Listen, while you're on a roll, if you feel like you gotta make, like, a Western omelet or something. Although, actually, I'm really not that hungry.
Oh, good. Lenny and Squiggy are here.
Morning. Morning.
Morning.
Morning.
Morning.
Morning, Paul.
Hello, Paul.
Hi. Paul, is it?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Stop.
No, I'm telling you, last night was like... It's like all my birthdays, both graduations, plus the barn-raising scene in Witness.
We'll talk later.
Yeah. Wasn't a real date. What the hell do you do on a real date?
Shut up and put my table back.
All right, kids, I gotta get to work. If I don't input those numbers, doesn't make much of a difference.
So, like, you guys all have jobs?
Yeah, we all have jobs. See, that's how we buy stuff.
Yeah, I'm an actor.
Wow. Would I have seen you in anything?
Oh, I doubt it. Mostly regional work.
Okay, unless you happen to catch the Wee Ones production of Pinocchio. At the Little Theater in the Park?
It was a job, all right?
Look, Geppetto, I'm a real live boy.
I will not take this abuse.
You're right, I'm sorry.
Once I was a wooden boy, a little...
We should both know that he's a dead man.
Well, Chandler.
So how you doing today? You sleep okay? Did you talk to Barry? I can't stop smiling. I can see that. You look like you slept with a hanger in your mouth. Marco?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's like that. With feelings.
Oh, wow. Are you in trouble? Big time.
On a wedding dress? Hardly used. I think we're getting a little ahead of ourselves here. Okay. I am just going to get up, go to work, and not think about him all day. Or else I'm just gonna get up and go to work.
Oh, wish me luck.
What for?
I'm gonna go get one of those job things.
Sex, didn't you? How do you do that? Aunt Roz through Paris jungle and you're having sex. So, who? You know, Paul? Paul the wine guy? Oh, yeah, I know Paul. You mean you know Paul like I know Paul? Are you kidding? I take credit for Paul. You know, before me, there was no snapping his turtle for 2 years.
Of course it was a line.
Why would anybody do something like that?
I assume we're looking for an answer more sophisticated than to get you into bed.
I hate men. I hate men.
Oh, no, don't hate. You don't want to put that out in the universe.
Is it like I have some sort of beacon that only dogs and men with severe emotional problems can hear?
All right, come here. Give me your feet.
I just thought he was nice, you know?
I can't believe you didn't know it was a lie.
Oh. Guess what?
You got a job?
Are you kidding? I'm trained for nothing. I was laughed out of 12 interviews today.
And yet you're surprisingly upbeat.
Well, you would be too if you found Joan and David boots on sale, 50% off.
Oh, how well you know me.
They're my new, I don't need a job, I don't need my parents, I've got great boots.
How'd you pay for them?
A credit card.
And who pays for that?
My father.
Oh, God, come on, you guys. Is this really necessary? I mean, I can stop charging anytime I want. Come on, Rachel. You can't live off your parents your whole life.
I know that. That's why I was getting married.
Come on, give her a break. It's hard being on your own for the first time.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I remember when I first came to this city. I was 14. My mom had just killed herself, and my stepdad was back in prison. And I got here, and I didn't know anybody. And I ended up living with this albino guy who was, like, cleaning windshields outside Port Authority. And then he killed himself. And then I found aromatherapy. So believe me, I know exactly how you feel.
The word you're looking for is... Anyway...
You ready to jump out of the airplane without a parachute? Come on, I can't do this.
You can, I know you can.
I don't think so.
Come on, you made coffee. You can do anything.
Scream.
Paul's watch. You just put it back where you found it.
Oh, boy.
All right. Good night, everybody.
I'm Liza Minnelli.